Mac. So.
Got you in LA in your teeny weeny yellow polka dot bikini.
Oh, you didn't hear me. I'm like, damn, I must be cut off. I want to speak on this. I know what you
want.
You good? I ain't that lady, I ain't gonna lie.
Big money when she talk to me. She can buy whatever. She don't need me, but she fuck with me.
She don't believe me, but
she
trust
me. She screaming easy when she fuck with me. Pull her like 2-3 in the truck with me. I like you up, but now you're stuck with me. None of these hoes gon' play me. Bust your pussy bomb, bust like a M80. Old school army raise me, it still fuck you pay me. Westside Compton made me, yo new dude from Jay's in LA. Yo teeny weeny yellow polka dot bikini. Swimming pool, it look like Fiji. Top down in the Lamborghini, yeah. Views they never seen, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, I'm doing what you got just to get. After the podcast, they done.
You're cooked.
We always try to warn them.
Yeah. All right, take it easy. We got a long conversation.
Literally, they don't
want to
listen.
Nobody here. People don't like, oh, I don't like juice.
Yeah, cool, but.
Okay.
We gonna do a lot of
fuck your ass up if you want to. Yeah. I can cuss, right? Because y'all be cussing.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Just making
so
sure.
You want to say.
Yeah. Okay. Just it's making sure.
Open mic.
Nigga shit
open
down.
Open mic. Open mic. All right. This is Wholesome Podcast. Wholesome B. Mitch. Trey with the hat today. Today we got Jam from the If Anyone Cares podcast.
Hey, in the building.
Check
this
shit out.
In the
building. Yes, definitely check this shit out.
But also,
check our shit out on Spotify, YouTube, Apple Podcasts. This nigga Trey, you know, he's living out there. He got going on.
Edit that shit.
I don't know what this nigga's talking about.
He said,
that's why
my business is out there.
Right, yeah. I don't even know. But so what I want to know today is like, so let's say somebody interviewed all your exes or.
Oh my God.
Or, you know, the people that you had like dated seriously. They interviewed them. What would they all like agree on in terms of you? Like, what would they agree on when they talking about you?
They would agree on a few things. They would agree that I'm a passionate lover, that I'm intense, and that I can be toxic.
Damn.
I think those three things are the things that they would agree on.
Yeah, that's it.
I think that what makes me toxic personally is that I stay with niggas too long.
That make you toxic because you stay with them too long?
Yes, because it comes to a point where it's like, I have to be accountable for the fact that I know this nigga is doing what he's doing, and I'm giving him chance after chance after chance. And so I'm staying longer than I need to in relationships.
You're an enabler.
Yeah. Talk to you, able toxicity.
Yes. Yep. Well, I used to. Past tense. I died. Okay. This new body? No, I don't do that. But right, like, I used to be with my exes, absolutely. I would, and I think it's because I'm a passionate lover, I want to give people the opportunity to get better, but niggas don't be wanting to get better.
But it's your fault if you harmed by it, but it ain't, necessarily a bad thing.
You trying to see the good in him, you think he gonna...
Right, but at what point, though? Because we talking about grown-ass men. Like, if we talking about, you know, a 15-year-old, even though I wouldn't do that, but, like, they don't know the better. But when you talking about a 25, 26, 27-year-old man, and he done cheated on me 7 times, at what point do I take accountability for dealing with this nigga shit? I don't have to deal with his shit.
Can't leave things on an odd number.
Wow. I mean, that's a good point. I should have waited to the 8th time. But I think that's what makes me toxic is I stay in relationships longer than I need to, and then I start to become bitter and resentful. And then I start to turn up. Does that make sense?
Yeah. Don't want to do anything that's going to change you.
Exactly.
You always want to be your true
exactly.
No matter what. Don't want no other man or person dictating that.
Exactly. Okay. And that's what happens. I let niggas change me, and I'm not sweet no more.
Right. Okay, that's
I become sour, and that I got to be accountable for that.
Because
I got to walk away.
Okay, that's understandable.
But they will say that I'm patient. Because I've been through some shit. I'm hella patient, and I do want to see people get better. I'll forgive you as long as you are dedicated to getting better. But at the same time, I think that's my own demise because these niggas don't be committed to getting better.
Right, yeah. No, you definitely got to, you know, take care of yourself in that.
You know.
There's nothing wrong with, like, sticking by that person though.
I be trying. I really do. Like with my last relationship, I went through some shit thinking and just falling for words. And that's, I think that's what makes me toxic too, is that I will listen to what a nigga telling me all day, but like ignore all his actions.
So you like words of affirmation.
Exactly. That's part of my love language. Quality time is my love language, and touch, but words of affirmation is important to me.
Words ain't shit. Show them motherfuckers.
Honestly, and that's what the thing is.
It's a bishop, you gotta communicate, you know what I'm saying?
Right, right. And so the nigga was talking hot shit, you know, telling me, I'm gonna marry you, I'm gonna do all this and that, and lots of stuff. But when I was looking at his actions, it's like, hold on, you don't actually want that. You sabotaging everything that you can to prevent that from happening.
Yeah, but I mean, just because, so he could say that and want that and still sabotage it, though. That's the thing, too.
And that's what... That's what makes niggas toxic, though. Like, if you don't all the way mean it, then why are you dating
me? He
mean
it, but you the one he married, but he might do a little bit of shit.
Okay, but if I do that, then I'm problematic. Then I'm crazy. Then I'm toxic. Exactly. That's what I'm saying. It's a double standard. It's a double standard.
Trey, what about you? What are they saying about you?
It might look like I don't care enough, even though my actions are pretty great for me, but I... They probably mad if
Hold on, you can't. This is what they saying. You can't qualify. But what you gonna say? They gonna say it doesn't look like your actions. Like,
they might think I'm too chill and shit. Okay. Like things like that. Like, cause I'm not gonna go back and forth. You know, some female might want drama. I might hang out too much. I got. I definitely had someone said I travel too much.
Somebody said you
travel too much. Are you traveling with women?
Nah.
Oh, that's wild, man.
That's wild.
Live your best life, King. She don't want you to succeed. You needed to leave her alone. What? She don't want you to grow, King.
Like maybe I live a lifestyle that's too much is for a person if the other person might want to settle down, and I'm just a chill ass nigga. So people might not like some. Not all women, but some women are very argumentative. They they want to test you to see if you care and shit. Like
they want to test you to see if you care.
Yeah, even though
that sounds toxic. Test nobody.
I'm like, I don't think women test men, but I think women do allow men to show themselves, and if they don't agree with what you show, then they will argue with you.
Well, then that's what I mean. So shit like that. How about you, Mr. B, man?
Yeah, that sounds like some toxic stuff. I don't know. Me, let's see. What would everybody say about me? They'd probably be like, they'd probably say something like, he don't really, he's a caring person, but he's not very expressive. He take too long to figure out if he want to be in a relationship or not. They definitely going to say that. They 100% going to say that. They're going to say he take too long. And then, I mean, they probably all going to agree that I'm a fun guy, but too fun. Like I'm the fun guy. Like I ain't really the get serious guy. They might say that. Like he just the fun guy.
I'll
tell you. So it's like, I mean, but what's wrong with being fun?
I got a question though. Why does it take you so long to settle down or know if she is the one? Why does it take y'all so long to decide?
Well, because to me, it's like this. Naturally, people are gonna show their best self. Initially, they want to impress you.
Right.
They want to show their best self, and it takes time for that to wear off.
Yeah.
It takes time for their best self to wear off to just see who they are on a regular basis because they want to constantly impress you, and they should want to.
Right.
But, I mean, that don't last forever.
Yeah, I ain't the nigga who's going to wife you first quarter because I want to know.
Except first quarter.
I want to know everything about you, feel me? From your flaws to the greater points of your life to, what makes you mad and sad and shit. Like, I want to know everything. I want to know your triggers. And did you get triggered for no fucking reason? I need to know that.
That's real.
On the flip side, though, taking so long, I mean, it don't always necessarily work in my favor.
Nah, nigga definitely lose some shit.
No, it doesn't. I'm like, why y'all be taking so long? But I don't understand.
Even though nigga lose some shit, they still single too. Everybody be single for the rest of their life.
Exactly.
Yeah,
would
that's
you,
real.
Really? So be like, what's the rush?
No, that'd be my biggest pet peeve. Stop fucking with me, but then you still single at the end of the day.
What everybody rushing for?
You ain't even found no husband.
Exactly.
You should have been married 2 weeks later.
Exactly.
You should have been married.
Me for taking too long.
That don't even make no sense.
Yeah, that's real shit.
One of my biggest pet peeves.
Like, what is the rush?
I think in women's defense, like, for a long time, society has pushed this notion that women can only be a wife and a mother. And I think that we're finally breaking out of that mold, if that makes sense.
Yeah, I don't even
And so
like
that is the rush. Because I'm 28 years old, and so I cried to my mom the other day. I'm like, yo, I'm 28. Like, what if I don't get married and have kids? Like, what does that mean for me? Because my maternal clock is running out, and I think...
Yeah, freedom age.
Oh, my God. Okay, but you're right, though. Technology is advancing, but I think that society has, like, painted this picture for women that you got to be married and have kids by a certain age. Nah. And so we put a lot of pressure on men to be like, yo, hurry up, so I can hurry up.
That shit more so will push a man away if they... If they're not talking about it first, or if y'all not talking about it together, you be the first one, oh, wow, I can't wait to get married. Damn, when you going to fucking, like, get on your knee, nigga type shit? Like, I think... Now we start pushing dudes away because if I ain't say it, why the fuck you bring it up?
But I mean, I think we bring it up because those are things that we want.
Been together for 17 years.
But we bring it up because we're setting a boundary, and these are things that we want out of life, we want y'all to respect that.
Somebody should bring it up because that boundary does have to be set. Where it's like,
how soon should they bring it up?
That's a good question. I think at least a year.
What do we consider bringing it up though?
Yeah, that's a good question.
Because, I mean, just having a discussion on, so what do you see in your future life? When do you see yourself getting married? When do you want to have kids?
Those are questions.
That's bringing it up, though.
Yeah, it is.
Like, that's different. Bringing it up, I'm like, damn, like...
Bringing it up with pressure.
With pressure with it?
Yeah, right. That's when the anxiety be rising.
To you.
Don't pressure me.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Is that okay?
Right.
When that part okay? When should a female pressure you when y'all been together 2, 3, 4 years?
I think if we've been together if we're in our mid to late 20s and we've been together for 2, 3, 4, 2 years, early 30s, because we changed in that narrative. 28, late 20s. If we've been together for 2 years, I'm going to ask eventually, because it's like, what are your intentions with me?
What are you going to ask exactly? Like, what are you going to ask?
I'm going to ask, what are your intentions? And to be honest, this is...
In 2 years?
Yes.
I'm still with you.
No. Because, in this day and age, people can... We're in a place where, first and foremost, I don't know if monogamy is necessarily natural.
No, it's not.
So we're moving in a day and age where you got people who want traditional marriage and you got people who don't. Mm-hmm. So it's like, if we get to that 2-year mark, are we just fucking for this experience and we're just together for this experience and when it fades out, it fades out?
Right.
Are we actually working towards something? Right. So that's why, when you spend two years, for me, is a lot. In 2 years, I'll be 30 years old. So I feel like
Gotta relax. That's not nothing. You gotta relax.
No, it's a lot. In my mind.
No, that's a good point, though, because I mean, that's a fair enough question where it's like, where are we going with this?
Right.
Where are we going with this?
And are we going on the same page?
And that's the thing, is I realize that niggas don't respect boundaries. Like, y'all don't lead with boundaries. Y'all don't move with boundaries. And so when we move with boundaries, y'all think we trying to constrict y'all, when in reality, we just trying to make ourselves safe. Nah. We just trying to make sure that we're good at the end of the day. And I feel like y'all don't move in that way. Y'all just be showing up to the altar sometimes. You know what I mean?
Sometimes,
like,
yeah. But
going with the flow.
Yeah, sometimes.
Trying to figure out situations.
But however, I do like when somebody presents their boundaries and I have the option because I don't mind saying yay or nay. True. I ain't that type of guy that's just going to say yeah just because. I don't mind saying no. I'm being like, what you going to do?
Right.
I don't mind that. I'm okay with that conflict.
Right. And I think a lot of women, like, we set our boundaries, but if we really like you, we'll fold on our boundaries. That's toxic. We shouldn't do that.
But that's why, guys, y'all got to be okay with women expressing what they feel is okay or not. Right. And just keeping it real with them about it. Being like...
And that's the piece. Y'all don't do that, though.
I agree most dudes don't.
Black men. Black men, they follow suit.
No. I agree. Most men don't. They'll say what they think they want to hear and they'll be like, nah, just stand firm on what you truly believe.
And that's the
problem.
They're
gonna fold anyway.
But that's the problem, though, is that y'all don't say what y'all really mean, and then y'all lead us on this big fairy tale, and then when we start having expectations from that fairy tale. We don't love fairy tales, but we take you at your word. You know, if you tell me something, you tell me you want to marry me, I'm going to take you fucking seriously. Because I ain't never thought, looked at myself as being a bitch that's married. So, if you tell me you want to marry me, it's like, okay, wait.
That's where I'm going with it, though. You feel me? It'll be a nigga like me, keep a G with you. I'm trying to fuck with you, see where it goes. But if our vibe is right, then it's long run type shit. It's going to be niggas lying to you first quarter. Damn.
First quarter.
Love at first sight. I think, you know, female I want to marry, whatever, woo, woo, woo. You're going to go with that nigga, even though he don't know shit about you, your flaws and shit. Yeah, I would go more toward that nigga than a nigga who kept it more G at a realistic common sense.
Okay,
level.
But what I will say though, it's not fair for men to sell that that persona, and y'all be doing that for the sake of y'all ego. I'm gonna go ahead and fluff this up and
no, that's the wrong thing.
But it happens.
It does happen.
Yeah.
Thank you. That's wrong. All I wanted to hear.
It does. Yeah. It happens a lot.
It's a lot.
Wrong, but y'all wrong for listening to that shit.
But why though? Because we taking you at face value. It's not my fault. You not being honest. Is that my problem?
No, it's not.
I mean, you got to weed the shit out. Like
what?
It's like this. Okay, yes, he said this, but slow your roll, partner. Like, let's.
I will say we do need to take a second to think.
Yes.
We do need, yes. But you gotta also realize that we have been fed Disney. We have been fed Disney all our lives. We've been fed this idea of fairy tales, and so like you can't necessarily blame us for that because that's all we know.
No, you can't blame you guys for
Disney,
that.
Disney movie made by white people.
Not all of them, but a few.
Most of them.
You're right.
Like Trey said, it is a matter of, okay, yeah, he said this, but you do got to kind of bring him through the ringer, see some actions to the align with that.
Do he really mean what he's saying?
You can't just go that off, is true. Completely off words.
That is true. We do be falling for the hype. We definitely do. But at the same time, it's just like, why do y'all even lead with that? Because if you weren't lying to begin with, then I know how to set myself up from the jump. But I can't, and it's like.
Everybody for self. Not everybody, but a lot of people sell.
And they are, but at the same time, lead with that energy. Don't act like you all about me and then switch up.
But, yeah. So why
for the sake of your ego.
No, not just for the sake of the ego, because...
Like I just said,
yeah.
I'm a nigga because I don't like lying to women. So I'm going to say what it is. But if I know it's other
you
niggas...
You might not get as far.
Yeah, if I know niggas who lie, who tell me they do this shit, and they good, like, the women are fucking with them just all because they saying all the lovey-dovey shit... It makes sense, cause
I'm gonna do what I'm gonna. What's gonna make me successful?
But that's manipulative. Do y'all not get that part?
No, it is.
Okay, I'm just letting y'all know.
But Trey is saying that so, like, when if a guy were to keep it real, he's probably not gonna get as far with this woman. Whereas the guy that's gonna lie gonna get much further than the guy that's keeping it real.
That's very true. But at the same time, it's not fair for you to take a good woman who has good intentions down this rabbit hole.
It's not business.
But what I'm telling you, especially in this season, if a nigga was to be like, yo, let's just fuck. All right. If you, I don't want nothing serious. All right. I can respect that. But when you start leading with a facade and lead me down a rabbit hole, then I become that toxic bitch that quote unquote is crazy. And then y'all want to tweet and be like, oh, this bitch is crazy. You know, you made me crazy.
I agree, but why do he have to care about your feelings?
But why don't you? Well, my thing is, though, that's the problem is that we think that love is all about us. And that is the problem. True. No, love is about the other person. If I love you, I'm in service of you. Well, I learn you.
I think it's about both people.
No, it definitely is. It absolutely is. Yeah. But at the same time, love is considerate. If you're going into a situation
being a person is considerate.
Absolutely. But even more so in love. So if you're going into it thinking about your benefits and what you can get, you already fucked up. The foundation is spoiled.
If people are naturally inconsiderate, just individuals being born, like just grew up inconsiderate, never really care about other people's feelings, how the fuck they gonna change when they try to pursue?
But that's not an excuse though, because if you want to pursue a woman and that particular woman, you gotta
pursue. He's saying he does. He just wanna fuck. Like,
but that's different. With that energy though, because there's women out here that just wanna fuck.
No, we feel you, but they gonna go with the winning thing. If I say I love you first, I know that's gonna win. It could be 50-50, say.
And that's toxic.
It is. Yeah. It's toxic. It's manipulation.
Yeah. But at least y'all know, because what?
I don't agree with it, but I know niggas who do it, and I understand why, but I would never.
Right. But that, at the same time, it's like, y'all know y'all are toxic, but y'all, in the same breath, it's not fair to sit here and call women crazy because they're reacting to the toxicity.
No. If you react crazily, you react crazy. Your reaction has nothing to do with the initial action.
But, no, it definitely does.
You
because
can decide how you react.
No, you definitely do, but at the same time, like I said at the beginning, I'm a patient person. So I'm a chill. I'm gonna give you a chance. But if you're sitting here feeding me hype saying, oh yeah, I'm gonna do better, and you still doing bullshit, I'm gonna pop the fuck off. Because why are you telling me you're gonna do better and you're still not? And you're still not.
Yes, it's a good point, Trey.
What do you say?
Y'all might got different level better. He probably making
the
most steps.
That's right.
Yeah, I trust
y'all.
I've been through this shit.
That's a, That's 100%
legit. Y'all are reaching.
Like, is that a reach?
Yes. Because it's like, that's another boundary that needs to be set.
No. Your perception of what's better doesn't mean it has to meet my perception of what's better.
Okay, your perception of what's better is your value. My perception of what's better is my value. If our values don't match, then what the fuck are we talking? Exactly.
But if you staying, then what are we talking about?
But that's what I said at the beginning of the podcast. That's what I said at the beginning of the podcast. That's what makes me toxic, is the fact that I see that you're not getting better to my... I'm not. And I'm the only one that can admit it, though. A lot of women don't want to be honest about the fact that you took that ain't shit nigga dick and you mad. And you mad because you took it. So I question, am I mad at you or am I mad at myself for allowing that shit to go on?
It's both. Because, I mean, like Trey said, I mean, if I say I'm better now, I'm doing better.
Because y'all are 31 years old. It's 25-year-olds that are fucking women up out here. And it's not okay. The streets is not safe.
It's 30 and 40, 50 years old.
True.
It's just true. You know what I'm saying? True. I mean, but for me, I know for me, my whole... After, like, you know, a few situations, I decided I wasn't in the business of hurting people's feelings. Like, I wasn't... By at least by sending them off and saying something like, you know,
when people do like that.
Some foul stuff. To be honest, I think it's a lot of men out here. I'm gonna just say this. I think it's a lot of men out here that are manipulative for the sake of their own insecurities and their own ego. I'm gonna just put that out there.
I've talked to dudes before, and
that's their game.
Yeah,
that's
wild. Yeah, some dude deliberately do shit like that. They are manipulative, they know.
So you controlling a beautiful being because you don't feel worthy in yourself.
No, because they can.
And so that makes you feel like a man because you're controlling this beautiful woman.
No, I don't know. I can't speak for them. They do because they can.
But that's wild. I think that is some of it. I think they do it.
Insecurity and because they can.
Yeah, so it's a form of insecurity.
But that's not love.
Because they don't think, they don't have the confidence to be able to keep it real. Yeah. That's why it's an insecurity.
That's wild.
Because it does take a lot. But
it does take a lot, to be honest.
It's not that wild, because you got to have a lot of confidence to be able to tell somebody something that's straight up and expect them to still go with it.
But my thing is, though. You sound like an asshole. But you do, but at the same time, if that's who you are, that's who you are. Stand on that shit.
But you, just because you stand on them, and you won't get the girl. You want to get the girl.
But my thing is, though, it shouldn't be about the girl. It should be about who you are at the end of the day.
That's how niggas operate. It's always about the girl.
No, this is what we talking about.
Y'all so toxic.
This is what we saying. Like, I'm that guy who keep a G, but then I sound like an asshole. I sound like a dickhead.
You don't sound like an asshole. At the end of the day, you might
tell me they said I'm an asshole.
They, all of that's agree. You asshole.
Okay. My thing is, I wouldn't call you an asshole. If you tell me straight up, I'm just trying to fuck, then okay, that's what it is. And if I expect or anticipate anything other than that,
and women, I'm not only trying to fuck. I want to be your friend and see where it grows and shit. Like,
but sometimes niggas just want to fuck.
Everyone
and y'all don't lead with that. But there's women out here.
No, lead with that. They get called.
But
asshole.
My thing is, though, what y'all do is y'all take the choice away from women, and that's what's manipulative. It's like, as a woman, I have a choice. Yes. Give me, put that on the table.
Look, every man, where the insecurity comes from. Every man might not be secure enough. Because if they come like, hey, I just want to fuck, she going to tell all her homegirls, then they going to know, oh, he a dog. All you want to do is fuck. Every man is not secure enough to say that. So you're going to say to every woman.
But that's not my problem. That's not my problem. Because you're not secure enough to tell me the truth is not my problem. So therefore, you feeding me lies and you mad because I'm reacting to your lies. That's not fair.
So your feelings is his problem. So you mad for him.
No, I'm mad because I feel the way I feel because of the lies that you're telling me. You got to be accountable for that. Don't feed me no bullshit and then be mad because I'm reacting to the bullshit you gave me.
But other women will hold this nigga to a different standard for saying you want to fuck. So he, I'm just saying, why should he care about your feelings? Like, if he going to get judged by other women, so you're just one of a million women. So one woman don't care about his feeling. Why are you going to care about yours?
Okay, my thing is, though, it's like, if you're only wanting to fuck, I don't expect you to care for my feelings. So tell me what it is straight up so I can choose for my fucking self. Don't lead with, you know, oh, I want this, I want that, and then just be trying to fuck.
Which,
that's what I'm saying.
You're correct. I think you're correct.
You're 100% correct.
Thank you. Yes. That's what I'm saying.
No, we didn't you're say
correct.
You were wrong.
Okay. You're correct. But however, say this guy leads with the lie, that don't give you the right to react wildly.
It doesn't. It gives me the option to react, though. I think that black women especially, we do be turning the fuck up. We be smashing nigga tires, windows, all of that. We shouldn't do that. But at the same time,
wait, fellas, when that happens,
call the police.
Please.
Okay, no, I definitely agree. We shouldn't overreact, but my thing is, though, we can still react because I've given you my time, I've given you my pussy, I've given you my energy, I've given you my money, so why the fuck can't I react when you've been feeding me?
No, you can react, but how should you react?
I think that we should react in a calm manner. We can be mad, but we don't have to be destructive in our anger.
There you go.
I agree with that. How you get back at a guy like him? Fuck your cousin, his daddy, his brother.
See, that's toxic. Y'all want us to be equally toxic, and we not trying to be that.
No, I don't want you to be toxic at all, but it is, you are afforded the opportunity to react. How you react is now on you. If you react in a toxic manner, that's now your fault.
But then, go ahead.
Then you can say, oh, I knew you like this, so this is why I ain't fuck with you, because you're toxic, because I knew you were going to get mad, you're just an angry individual.
But my thing is, though, half the time, the reason that we react like that is because of our own childhood trauma, so we do need to address that up front.
True.
But at the same time, my thing is, y'all are feeding us triggers to make us react in that way. Women be patient as fuck.
Most times,
a woman's going to let a nigga slide at least one time. At least. It might take her a little bit, but she gonna let a nigga slide at least one time. So why do you continue to feed me bullshit? And then you get mad and want to call me crazy. Reactive. Yes. Y'all gotta look up reactive abuse. Because when women be turning up and going crazy, niggas just be sitting there because you know why she's mad. You know why she's angry.
But here's the thing, though. Just because I know why you mad don't give you the right to do certain
things. And you're absolutely right. But at the same time, like, if you... Okay, for example, like... If you get mad and you start slamming stuff, it doesn't make you right, but your feelings are still valid. The way that I react is trash, but my feelings at the end of the day are still valid. And y'all be ignoring our feelings.
If a man do you wrong, probably lied to you, probably cheated on you, is it right for you to hit him?
It's not right for anybody to hit anybody.
Exactly.
It's not right for anybody to hit anybody. I'm not saying that the way that we react is okay. It's toxic.
Yeah.
But in the same breath, my feelings behind that reaction are valid. And when you call me crazy, you dismiss my feelings.
And so the thing with that is, depending on how you react, that can possibly mask what I'm interpreting as your feelings. So it's hard for me to interpret if you're breaking my shit.
But my okay.
What the hell are you doing? What type of footage you
but
talking
my
about?
Thing,
you
but, my I shit? Th- but in the same breath, you. But my in the same breath, you know exactly why I'm mad. So don't act dumb.
But I don't know.
That's
how
my
you're
thing.
Feeling though.
If I'm breaking your shit, I'm pissed. Don't play dumb. That's my thing.
But it's really the fact that you're hurt. You're hurt by the fact that I did this, but I can't differentiate that because you're just breaking shit. You're fighting all this other shit.
Can your voice? It's okay.
But my thing is though, we communicate with y'all and y'all still go back out and do the same dog shit. So for example, with my ex, I calm every time. That's a shame. But every time this man told me, "Oh, I cheated on you," I was calm. I had to think about this.
That?
Yes. Oh, I was calm. Because he knew I was a patient bitch. I don't know. But I was calm. I was cool. I had to think about this. I was calm, cool, and collected. But then it got to a point where I realized you are still doing the same toxic behavior. So at what point do I get to turn the fuck up?
I guess.
At what point do I get to be mad?
Oh, wait.
Future reference. If a nigga just tell you, I cheated on you. Guess he's trying to test that shit out.
Yeah, I know now.
If you were chilling the first time. What's the
but
mean?
But that's
to
okay. But y'all
time.
See the hypocrisy. Y'all see the hypocrisy though.
No.
Because y'all no listen. Because if I'm chill the first time, you take that as okay. It's okay to do it again. No, listen. That's what you just said. Okay. So if I'm chill the first time, it's like okay. I want to see how you react. That's what you said. But if I turn the fuck up, then I'm crazy. There's no middleman. There's no in between.
No, the
in between. You can be chill the first time and like, I'm done fucking with you. And let him chase you. Like,
and that's what it really comes down to. Women be too forgiving. I will admit that.
So, like Trey said.
Be like, oh, word, that's cool. Well, I'm done with
but
you.
But at the same time, because we really love y'all.
So what?
Yes.
So here's what it comes down to. Is that love worth your own
But I will admit that a lot of women don't be loving themselves enough to know that it's not worth it. And that's why we stay. That's why we stay is because we don't love ourselves. So we sitting here taking that ain't shit nigga dick.
Everybody's valuable.
Then that's that confidence thing where it's like, I got the confidence. I'm leaving you if you do this to me.
Right.
Do you understand? You got to explain something sometime. Like, do you understand? I'm finna leave your ass.
Right.
It really break it down. But that's that communication, confidence.
Leave him for a little bit. Let him change you for a month until No,
leave, not a mother leave too. Good.
Like, leave, though, I'm leaving you. Right. Come find me. Oh, yeah. And if you don't,
but my thing is though, my thing is though, we should leave, and I agree with you, and that's why I said what I started with that. That's what makes me toxic, is I don't leave. But
you stay. Now you.
But my thing is though, wait. If I call you out on your shit, don't butter me up. Let me leave. When I think about it, I tried to leave my last relationship 6 times. That screams abuse. That screams manipulation. Huh? Don't try to
butter. You ain't leave.
Okay, but listen. Don't try. Exact. But my thing is though. Don't. It is definitely. Did not leave with that though. It definitely is my bad. Mm-hmm. But my thing is though. If you know you wrong, be accountable for that wrong and let me walk away. Let me walk away.
If you can talk, you understand. Then what?
And that's what makes y'all toxic. And y'all want to be toxic. Y'all love that game, and that's toxic. But y'all say y'all love women, but y'all don't even be trying to help us love ourselves. That is toxic.
No, you should love yourself.
No, you definitely did. You definitely should.
I can't help you love yourself.
No, you definitely should. I should definitely love myself beforehand. But if you say that you love me, why don't you not love me enough to stop fucking me up?
I will love you better. You already love yourself.
No, absolutely. You're definitely right. But again, if you truly love me, then why aren't you honest about the fact that you're fucking me up? That's what I'm saying. Y'all try to get away with as much as y'all can get away with, and that's manipulative. That's not love.
That is manipulative for me. Yeah.
It's not love.
I'm fucking up. I'll leave you because I'm fucking up. Well, I do that.
Men don't do that, though.
I don't want to affect your mental health like that. I believe.
Because that's what makes us crazy.
If I can talk good enough and you stay, I'm
fucking up. I know it's going to turn crazy at some point.
It always does.
No, it always does not. That's not.
Most time, 9 times out of 10, it does turn crazy. That's a problem.
Somebody gotta leave.
If I know every time it's crazy though, then that's an issue.
Like somebody gotta leave before it gets crazy. That's the biggest thing. It's like people, like you said, stay too long, and therefore it flips the script. Somebody needs to leave before then on both sides.
And I talked to people before, like who's in like toxic ass relationship. They stay or go back. Because it's comfortable. That's what they know. Comfortability.
You gotta move footsteps in the dark.
Everybody not used or okay with just venturing out, like doing something to make them uncomfortable and like expanding their experience or horizon just in other people and themselves.
And to me, that's still a confidence thing. Is having the confidence to say, I'm comfortable wherever. Yeah,
right. But that's the problem.
Insecure as well.
It is. That's the problem. So my thing is, why are we dating if we're still insecure? And nobody wants to admit that they're insecure.
Part of dating is being insecure.
Yeah.
I mean, to be honest, relationships do teach you about yourself.
They do. A lot of
insecure people are in relationships because they don't like being by themselves.
That's a problem. If anything, 2020 should have taught us. But that shouldn't be it. If I'm in a relationship, it's because I appreciate you for who you are and I want to help you get to where the fuck you going.
But have you helped yourself, though?
But my thing is, though, absolutely, I definitely have. No, but my thing is, at the point that I was in a bag. But I realized the things that were happening in this relationship were fucking me up. So what did I do? I removed myself. It's a lot of niggas that get in relationships just to feel themselves, just to feel like that nigga. When there's women out here that are actually wholeheartedly looking for love, looking to create families. So y'all getting in relationships for the wrong fucking reason to begin with. So the foundation is already fucked, and y'all don't want to be accountable for that.
I ain't gonna lie, I feel so uncomfortable with the y'all word. Can you just say?
I'm sorry.
Because I mean, to be honest, I mean, me and Chad, we okay with being by ourselves.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
That's why we take so long.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
Exactly. I've been single since 2011.
Niggas.
Like, so I mean, yeah, it's 2021. Yeah. 10 years.
I don't mean to be offensive, but my words are for who they're for. You know, because the niggas that know, they know.
But,
you know, I'm talking
about
you.
Like we said, we do 100% agree with you. There's dudes like that. We did not want.
I agree.
But we agree, like. Yeah, niggas are foul.
Foul as hell. Y'all be toxic and y'all know y'all be toxic.
So, right.
And that's the thing.
People be toxic.
The thing is, I feel like...
People.
True,
yeah,
true.
Yeah, you're toxic as women.
Okay, but I think the difference is that women sometimes aren't aware of the fact that they're toxic.
I said niggas are too.
Yeah. Like, niggas intentionally do that. Yeah.
But my thing, that's what I'm saying, is that sometimes, like, for me, I wasn't aware that I was toxic until recently. Men be knowing... And still be showing up in relationships. That's toxic.
Women literally do the same.
Okay, you said women, but not this woman. Yeah. You know what I mean? Like, I didn't know I wasn't. I didn't know I was toxic.
Right, it took some time.
At least you were able to learn yourself.
Right, that's the truth. A lot of women don't take that time. They just be hopping to the next relationship.
You gotta take time on yourself.
So, based off that, what y'all saying, man, what is y'all, like, terms of agreement for dating with intentions? Like, how do y'all date then? Y'all date and especially, so you saying you want to keep it a buck up front.
Yeah. My thing is just set the precedent. And if I was actually just talked about this in my podcast today, it's like I have values, and so I'm always gonna leave my values. But my power is that I can change my values. So, for example, with my ex, we started off as friends with benefits. I was cool with that because of where I was in my life. Right. I realized I fell for this nigga. So therefore, hey, can we be something? Yes or no? You know what I mean?
Asked that question.
I asked that question.
That's fair.
You know what I mean?
That's good, though.
And so the problem was that's great communication. I thought so. Yeah. And so he tells me no. Okay, well, I'm going to move my black ass on because that's what I should
do.
Wait,
why?
because it got to a point where it's like, I can't fuck you and not love you and not want more with you. So therefore, I have to remove myself so I'm not that crazy bitch.
So if he wanted to continue having sex with you, he had to say yeah, even though that's not what he wanted?
Yeah, because it got to a point where it was too much.
I think my point was just proven.
No. We were fucking for 3 years. We were fucking friends with benefits for 3 years. My value changed. So therefore, I had to move around because I can't continue to fuck you without my heart being involved at this point. So therefore, I'm going to remove myself from the situation. Now, when you see me talking to somebody else, all of a sudden you wanna hop on my bandwagon. You wanna be about me. Now you love me. Now, see, that's toxic. You don't want me.
That's toxic.
It absolutely is, because do you actually love me, or do you just miss the benefits that I was giving you?
Or he could just possibly not know how to express himself. It could be a few things within that. I mean,
the timing is terrible. But don't tell me no initially and then change your mind.
Why, nigga, can't change his mind?
And you change your mind after I start talking to somebody else.
Women change their mind all the time. I don't know what to eat. Oh, why you give me Chick-fil-A? I want tacos.
Wow.
There's nothing wrong with changing your mind.
No, you definitely can change your mind. I'm not saying that you can't.
Or coming to a realization like, maybe I do want more.
But my thing is, though, I think a lot of men, they don't understand the difference between love and benefits. And that's what it is. Do you love me or do you love fucking me?
They know the difference. They love your pussy.
And that's what I'm saying. Do you love me or do you love fucking me? Because there's a difference. So don't sit there and tell me you're ready for a relationship.
What's the difference? I'm going to be honest. Who knows the difference? Who knows the difference? How do you know the difference?
Yeah, good pussy hard to find all the time.
Wow.
Like, you said, if it's good, they gonna come back. Like, why would you want to leave that alone?
But my thing is, though, if you want to fuck me and I'm telling you that I have feelings for you, now you are now responsible for the fact that my heart is involved in this. You can't fuck me without repercussions. Before, you could, but I'm changing that standard. And y'all don't be respecting boundaries. When I tell you that I want...
That's a tough boundary to respect.
But my thing is, though, like, it is what it is, though. I'm setting my boundary, respect it or not. If you want to continue to fuck me, listen, we got to be in a relationship. We got to be exclusive. You can't be fucking who this person and that person.
So I got to stop abruptly what I've been doing for 3 years?
Yes, absolutely.
That's unrealistic.
Why is that unrealistic, though? Because if you say I gotta consider your feeling, but you don't have to consider mine, that's
no,
what I'm
it's
saying.
Considering both, it's a two way street.
But my thing is that we can just simply stop talking. I'm giving you an ultimatum.
It like this.
No.
It like this.
What? It's, you want me? My thing is, though, you want me to waver on my boundary for your benefit, but you wouldn't do the same.
It was anything. Can a person with cigarette who smokes cigarette just stop? Just cold
absolutely,
because
my mama did.
Can niggas smoke crack stop cold turkey?
And they can.
Can alcoholics?
It's the percentage of people that are.
It's not my fault you're addicted to my vagina. That is not my problem. Let's be honest. It's not my fault that you are addicted to my vagina.
Can you not be respectful of my feelings, though?
But I am. I am, and that's why I'm giving you an option. That's why I'm respectful of your feelings, because I'm telling you, hey, I like fucking you, but I love you at this point. So therefore, if we want to continue to fuck, I cannot continue to do this.
You want me to harm myself
for the benefit of your dick? That's toxic. All
right, but
that's good. That's a good communication.
If that guy may be fucking 3 or 4 women and then he's pursuing you, he can't just start talking right away. It might take some...
That's an excuse.
Weeks, a month, a year.
Why not? That's the problem, is that you're addicted to my vagina, and that is not my problem. My vagina has consequences. That's what y'all don't understand. Pussy has consequences.
I know women can do it, but all men can't.
Why not?
Just,
why not?
It's
why
it
not?
Don't make sense.
Why not?
It's not realistic.
Yeah, no.
It is realistic.
So let me tell you why it's not. So
if you want to quit a job, do you quit the job or not?
This time I'm reverted back to what Trey said earlier. So this is what. That's good communication on your part as a woman.
Thank you. I'm setting boundaries. So I know
for sure. But what happens then is now this guy has to make a split decision,
and that's not my problem.
Do I lie or do I tell the truth?
And just like you don't want your feelings hurt, he don't want to hurt their feelings.
But no, look.
Either.
So if he lies and says, "Yes, I cut everybody off," now he get caught cheating. If he keeps it real and says, "No, I'm not ready for that,"
But that's not my...
He can't get you.
But
no
my
more.
Thing is, you said out of your own mouth, everybody leading for themselves. So why the fuck can't I lead for myself?
You can't.
Exactly. You can't. So if I want to cut you off because your dick is hurting my heart, then I can do that.
And he got to write a lot of you.
No, that's not how that works. Y'all niggas is so toxic. That's not how that works. You can't lie for the benefit of my pussy. That's not fair.
And you can't
I can.
Tell the truth on benefit yes, I of
can.
Yours either.
Yes, I can. Absolutely the fuck I can. Especially when I'm the one who has to bear the consequence of the fact that I could get pregnant.
But what if he communicates like, hey, I'm not ready for that right now.
I like you, but I'm not ready to care about
you. And if I communicate, hey, that's fine, but I can't fuck you no more. Why can't I communicate that?
I hate when people give somebody else an ultimatum.
But that's why niggas lie.
Why not? That's what a boundary is.
That should have been said. So before you got to the point where it's just an ultimatum.
But why can't I change? You literally said people can change their minds. So why the fuck can't I change mine?
You can. But however, that should have been established. It shouldn't be.
It was established, but I changed. You talking about I was fucking somebody for three. Listen, I was fucking somebody for 3 years of my life. In that 3 years, my black ass grew. So therefore, I can't fuck with you anymore.
He grew in a different way.
So what I'm not,
and therefore, our paths need to.
They might go separate.
Let me tell you something. They made hella men and hella women on Valentine's Day this last Sunday. They're not done making men and women. So therefore, there is another pussy can satisfy you besides mine.
It's always a new crop coming.
Every June.
Okay. Every June,
they graduate from college.
And November. Crop. Shit. Like, so that's not my fault that you're addicted to my vagina.
But my whole thing was the same, like, there should be a gradual period. So you let me know.
We're not in a relationship. There's no.
I'll tell you why. I can easily tell you why. Okay. As you're starting to catch these feelings, you communicate that to me. Now I know where you're going.
Yeah, I could, but I'm able to take it more serious now.
Exactly. I could decide what I want to do.
But my thing is, though, I
you gradually gained feelings, and you gradually didn't tell me.
Okay, yeah, but my thing is, though, you're absolutely right, but at the same time, I was able to control it at a point. Now it's at a point.
I don't want you gotta communicate, though.
Well, why? Because y'all
don't
Hold on, wait. When y'all be fucking other people, y'all don't be communicating, so why the fuck do I gotta communicate when my feelings are at capacity? That's some bullshit. That's a double standard.
That's not the same. It's not the same because.
Y'all are so toxic.
Whoever he fucking got shit to do with you, whatever. Vimmy, play safe, Joe. Still play safe. He let you know he might be fucking other people, but it don't matter who. But if you're getting feeling for an individual,
but
tell him why it's growing. Don't tell him when it's already there.
No. Because if it's growing,
tell him.
Okay, but no. It's growing, but it's not out of control because I'm still able to manage.
It's not out of control.
But my thing is that if y'all don't have to consider me, why the fuck do I got to consider you? Nigga, this is what it is. Why do I have to ask permission?
Part of saying what it is, hey, I'm gaining feelings. What you want to do?
And I did that. I didn't do it in the timing that y'all would have allowed, but I did it in my. But my thing is, it's my body. You are fucking me, sir. Why do I have to move on your time? My thing is, why do I have to move on your time? And that's what men don't understand. Is no, but y'all want us to abide and move on your time. When I'm at capacity, I'm at capacity. That's not my problem.
No, stop before the capacity.
No, I just want to spread. I want you.
Why? Because you want to keep fucking me. That's why you want me to stop before the capacity.
No. We want you. Express yourself at the right time. So before you already in love with him, you fucking.
But my thing is though. I wasn't in love though.
You weren't, but you strongly were liking him. When that inclination of feeling came in, let him know then.
But my thing is, I gotta have some type of feelings to fuck you anyways. So again, why do I have to have this emotional gauge? Oh well, I'm at 75%. So let me tell this nigga.
That's 45.
Like, be realistic.
But I am being real. I'm doing the thing that niggas don't do. I'm telling you straight up, I can't fuck you anymore just for fun. I want something more. So what? If you ask, but my thing is though, if you actually want me, make your decision and then chase me.
That's what I'm saying though. Why do I have to have this or that? Why can't you let me know before then?
Because everything
and
in
I
this
have some time everything, to think everything, about it. Nigga can't even think.
My thing is though, if we're just fucking and that's what you want to continue to do, then that's fine. Take your time to think. And in this instance, the dude did take his time to think. He told me, probably not. I went on to talk to other people. He came back and shot a shot and he made it. That's what it is.
I need 5 to 7 weeks to think about it.
Yeah, that's not my problem though. That's not my problem. You gotta be accountable. That's not my problem.
Just like college or high school, you taking a test. can you make a decision in a split second, or it takes
sometimes
some time?
You have to though.
No.
What? Why you gonna get the answer wrong?
I want to prepare.
Yeah.
But my thing is though, it's not my job to prepare you.
No, it's my job to prepare me. So I'm gonna say, get some time to think about
realistic.
It.
But my thing is though, why do I have to give you rights to my pussy as you think about it? That's what y'all not understanding. That's the part that you're not getting. I get to decide what happens with this vagina.
You decide whatever you want.
You ain't gotta fuck him no more. But then the courting stage get realer. But still, let him know you should still.
And I did let him know. I just
you still could hang out with him, go on dates. But make because it a proper thing. You ain't gotta cut him off completely.
I will say we were good friends, and that's what I told him is like, we can continue to be friends, but I'm not gonna continue to fuck you because this is taxing on my spirit. That's just what it is. Why do I have to move on your time? Why do I have to be always sensitive to your feelings when niggas are the least sensitive to women's feelings? And y'all know y'all are.
Let me ask you this then.
Mm-hmm.
So how do you know when you're at that point where it's like, now it's time to have that conversation?
When I'm looking at your Twitter, not only your Twitter page, but I'm looking at your Twitter likes every day, it's a problem.
No.
My thing is though, like, they have a section for the likes, the things that people like. Like, if you go on Twitter and you like something, my thing is, because if you look at somebody's likes on Twitter, that's a way to understand
that.
I got
a funny story. I hope she don't watch this shit. But it's someone who just really liked me a lot at one point.
Yeah.
Might still do. I don't fucking know. But, so sometimes I put my Twitter's, what I say on Twitter, I'm a snapper shit. She was not my Twitter friend. Did probably 2020, 2019. She going back to what I said, 2017, mm-hmm. 16, 15.
That's how you know.
And she was not my Twitter friend.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. That's what Twitter. I'm saying. So when it gets to that point where I'm stalking your social media, oh yeah, I'm in too deep. I got to make a decision for my own safety.
That's a little bit much.
I don't judge nobody. I mean, everybody like people.
But my thing is, if I'm curious about you, I'm going to do what I can to learn about you. And social media is a way to do that. Yeah, what you put on social media.
No. That's the 2021 wrong way to do it.
True. But at the same time.
I wouldn't go about things like that. But I would not nobody who's doing it.
Okay, but true. But at the same time, it's not my fault if you're falsifying who you are on social media. I'm gonna still look at your social media.
Entertainment first and foremost.
At the same time, not everybody uses social media in that way. Because for me, I don't tweet fake stuff. Who you get on this podcast is who you get on Twitter, who you get on Instagram, who you get on
Social media not meant to be real.
If you put it like this for me,
but there's real people on social media. Okay. And my thing is, you saying nah, but at the same time, even still, even if it's not real, it's perceived as real. That's the way that technology is moving. And if you're not giving me no feelings, you're just fucking me. I'm looking for anything I can to understand who you are.
Before. Every day before I go to work on my Snap, I posted Church of Scientology on my shit. I don't go there. I post it. People just swear I go there. Why do I gotta go there?
I post it every day.
Yeah, don't.
You swear he's a Scientologist.
It don't make it real.
My thing is though, why are you lying on social media?
It's
not my fault that you're putting out a false perception of who you are on social media. But it's not my fault that you're putting out a false perception of who you are.
It's just scenery. Why not post it?
Because what I'm telling you is that there are some people who don't use social media in that way. There's some people who are authentically who they are. Yeah. So how am I supposed to decipher?
If you know me, talk to me.
Yeah,
but my thing is, okay, I did. But I'm also looking at your tweets. I'm not judging you, but I'm
It's always a judgment factor.
Subconsciously, it's always a judgment factor.
My thing is, I'm taking this information in, but I'm not necessarily judging you. Because if I was judging you, I would have made a decision based on your social media. I took the time to ask you if you could be something. That's a difference. I'm taking in who you perceive yourself to be, but I'm asking you one-on-one. Can we be something? He's one of the realest niggas on social media. He don't tweet. That's what I'm saying. Is for me, if you look at my Twitter, the way that I talk is the way that I tweet. Not everybody's fake on social media. And that's why I personally limit my time on social media because I'm a real ass nigga on social media. You know, but not everybody is fake. Not everybody has
that
perception.
What I do on social media ain't what I do in real life.
But that's not my problem.
But if you know me, I did though.
That's what y'all not understand it.
So what? So that the two? Then you would if you ask me, you talk to me, then you understand.
I'm saying, but everybody different.
Hold on. So you understand the two don't correlate, though.
But sometimes they do, is what I'm telling you. And sometimes when we look at social media, we're not even able to come to a conclusion. So what do I do?
You ask the question.
Exactly.
Yeah, but my point is everyone's different. That might be some people's real life, but might not be.
What y'all don't understand, though, is even if it's not your real life, why do I have to lead with the assumption that it's not your real life?
Don't look at my shit.
No, I'm okay with you assuming that's my real life.
But my thing is, though, even if it's not your real life, it's a perception of who you want to be.
Cool.
I'm still going to take that in because that's who you are to an extent, right?
Cool.
Right?
Yeah.
Great. And yeah. So my thing is, why?
I don't want to be a Scientologist. I don't want
to
be.
But my thing is, though, why do I have to sit there and believe another notion of who you pretend to be?
You can believe what you want to believe, and I'm okay with you just judging me based off my social media. I'm personally okay with that. Until you come to me, I'm going to assume that you don't really know me.
Yeah.
So therefore, I can't take you serious. I can't do nothing because you only know me from social media. Exactly. Let's treat it like that then.
But my thing is, okay, and you're absolutely right to an extent, though.
Until you want to get to know me deeper,
but okay, and
let's keep it at face value, yeah. Social media.
But okay. And the thing is, though, like, y'all want to sit there and say, oh, you want to know me deeper. But when a woman does try to be vulnerable with you, when she does try to be, y'all want to be standoffish. Y'all don't want to give a bitch too much. Let's be honest about
that.
Over
time.
Y'all want me to be open. Y'all want me to be open and busted open. But y'all don't want to sit there and tell me about your demons. Like, it doesn't equate the same.
And we're going to learn my demons together. I might not got none. But
in the context, though, if we're just fucking... It takes a while. It takes a minute.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So, like, if we're just fucking, what time do I have to get to know you?
I mean,
and so,
between
your mannerisms and what you post on social media, okay, even if that's a persona, I'm piecing it together.
Yeah,
and because I think I love you. Let me not even say I love you. I think I love you.
Based
on the perception of who you've shown me to be, it's not just the penis. But based on who you show me to be, I'm piecing shit together and I'm coming to a conclusion I might like this nigga.
Y'all going on any dates in between the time?
I mean, it was a really complicated situation because we were college like best friends and we ran the BSU together. So it's a very complicated situation.
But I'm going to say this. Even if y'all don't go on dates, whether you do or you don't, as an adult, you can't be scared to ask questions about somebody you have.
But you're talking. Oh no, and I did though. That's what y'all don't understand. I ask questions.
So once you ask those questions, they gotta answer them questions.
Exactly. And when they answer the question, I have a choice to move based on that answer. You're sitting and y'all sat there and told me that I didn't have that choice. I need to ease a nigga into it. No.
In terms of what you're expressing.
Yeah.
You need to ease into what
you're
expressing.
No, why? Y'all don't. When y'all cut a bitch off for another bitch, y'all don't explain shit. Y'all just be gone. Y'all be ghosting. Why do I have to take the time to ease you into some shit?
I ain't cut a bitch off another bitch in a long time.
Okay, y'all. Men. Them. Whoever that is.
Back in the day, though.
Y'all be ghosting women. So why do I have to sit here and do things that you wouldn't do? That's trash. That's toxic. It's a double standard. Y'all don't treat women to the same standard that y'all treat yourselves.
I'm okay with somebody cutting me off another nigga.
For most men. For most men, it's a double standard, though.
I'm okay with it. That's how they feel.
And at the end of the day, you can't just say y'all for everybody. It's big chump who might do. But
a lot
still,
of people,
everybody, individuals, gotta find the niggas who don't do that. It's still hella niggas.
And my thing, and the thing is, we trying to find them niggas, but y'all be lying about who y'all are from jump.
Lying who they are.
Nigga, thank you. That's all I'm saying is niggas be lying about who they are.
Niggas be lying about who they
are. And
then
they be mad when you don't understand who they are. You lying, dog.
Niggas be lying about who they are.
Yeah, that too. And some women.
That's foul.
Yeah, that's
foul as hell.
That's foul, but some women just ain't good at looking either.
That's true. Because it ain't hard to tell when a nigga lying about who he is.
Yeah, and if we can go either way, but
yes, it'd be like, you know, 60% of niggas lying about that.
Yeah.
75.
Okay, 75. But if your eyes is closed and you're oblivious to the fact that he lying, do it matter?
Or if you look in the same fucking place that you were the next nigga, like...
That's on you. At some point, it's on you to catch.
But at the same time, y'all sit there and say it's on you. But my thing is, you ain't never got. You ain't never
everybody
bought.
Got that.
Okay,
everybody.
Then. So my thing is,
though, then I look elsewhere.
Look elsewhere.
But
look
my thing is, we do. We definitely do. We be moving on, and then as soon as we move on, what do y'all want to do? Double back? Hold on.
I missed for the same nigga who just showed you the wrong shit. Yo, bad.
And no, it definitely. And what did I lead with, though? That's what makes me toxic.
Yeah, you know, but yeah. It's not about growing. You learn it.
Yeah, I absolutely. Shit. Yeah. Let a nigga fuck me over in this season. Cheers. Okay.
And, I mean, with all that being said, you know, we all know the facts, but the fact of the matter is that black men don't cheat.
Happy Black History Month.
We appreciate you, Jan, for coming through.
Wow.
If anyone cares, podcast. You know, y'all make sure y'all check it out. Spotify, Apple.
All that shit.
Yes, definitely.
I can't stand y'all.